One Blood, Redeeming the Time Brothers podcast, a podcast by Gene Kissinger and Norman Kissinger, two brothers who have spent their lives in ministry and raising large families. Our desire is to provide a digital place for those who long to belong. And as always, we want to leave a nightlight on for you. That nightlight is out of Acts chapter 17, starting in verse 22 down through verse 27. The Apostle Paul on Mars Hill in Greece, as he's talking right in outside of Athens, as he's talking to the Greeks about Christ. And he says, "Then Paul stood in the midst of Mars Hill and said, 'Ye men of Athens, I perceive that in all things ye are too superstitious. For as I passed by and beheld your devotions, I found an altar with this inscription, to the unknown God,'" in case they had skipped one out of all the pantheon of gods they had, "'whom therefore ye ignorantly worship him, declare I unto you, God that made the world and all things therein, seeing that he is Lord of heaven and earth, dwelleth not in temples made with hands, neither is worshipped with men's hands as though he needed anything, seeing he giveth to all life and breath and all things. And he hath made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on the face of the earth, and hath determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation, that they should seek the Lord, if happily they might feel after him and find him, though he be not far from every one of us." I've had the privilege of standing on Mars Hill where Paul preached this sermon. This sermon is, this verse that the God had made of one blood all nations is etched into a stone at the base of Mars Hill. As you climb up to the top of Mars Hill, you can look over and see the Acropolis, the remains of the Acropolis, where the Greeks had a way that was marked with various signs or little statues of gods that they worshiped, representing those gods. And you could look over on another place and you could see the Bema Seat, the remains of the Bema Seat, the place where democracy was born, where the very first votes were taken and citizens voted. And when I was on Mars Hill where it said God hath made of one blood all nations, I looked around and there were groups that were from Japan, and there were other groups there from Nigeria and others from Germany and other places. And you could hear the guide speaking in different languages, telling the story of Paul and Mars Hill and the Acropolis and what the Greek culture was like. But then the most profound experience I had with this was in the Garden Tomb, where just outside of Jerusalem, as we concluded our journey, we took the bus to Jerusalem, and then we took a tour of Jerusalem, and just outside of Jerusalem is the Garden Tomb. And when you go into this beautiful garden-like setting, there were little alcoves where people would stop, and you could hear hymns like Amazing Grace being sung in Japanese, or some other great Christian hymn being sung in Nigerian, and on, there are all kinds of languages where worship and praise was going up to God, and it just made me think about what heaven will be like. And today I preached a sermon for the second time that it's ever happened to me. I had a translator. Paloma translated for me at the Rupert Free Will Baptist Church. It was a bilingual service, and as I heard the gospel going out in another tongue, another language, it made me think of Mars Hill. It made me think of the Garden Tomb, and how one day you and I will all be together, of every nation, kindred, tribe, and tongue. We will be gathered around the throne of God, and we will be singing, "Holy, holy, holy, worthy is the Lamb." We'll be singing, "The mercy of the Lord endures forever." And those songs will maybe go up in multitudes of tongues and multitudes of languages. And we'll look around and a rainbow of people will be there, of every skin tone, of every ethnicity. And what an amazing thing that we'll be together there worshiping the God, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, part of the General Assembly of the Church of the Firstborn. And it's going to be magnificent. It's going to be awe-inspiring. Probably one of the closest experiences that I ever had to this was in Portland, Oregon, in the Coliseum. that was there. Bill Gothard had a seminar, and there literally were thousands and thousands of believers that were there of just every nationality. And there we were singing praises to God, and we sang a cappella, and the music was just so breathtaking to hear these multitudes of voices of every timbre and type flowing up to God. I got to tell you, if you've got any hate in your heart towards any other ethnicity, you need to banish it. If you've got any hatred for people that are different than you, banish it. Because heaven is going to be a place where we are gathered together, and all that divides us will dissipate and disappear, and we will God will have made of one blood all nations. What a good God we serve. Let us pray. Dear Lord God, I thank you for this day, and I thank you for these dear believers under the sound of my voice. Grant them a supernatural sense of your presence as we gather together tonight around these thoughts that Paul preached on Mars Hill. Thank you, God, that one day we'll be able to be together in heaven, not separated by any misunderstandings or any that would try to intentionally separate us, but we'll be able to worship you with full throat, with vibrant hearts, with passionate lips. We will praise you in our languages that will arise together in a glossolalia of love language to you. Thank you for all that you've done. Watch out over us on this night. In Jesus' most holy, precious, and powerful name, amen. God bless you.